Hi, good morning everyone. How are you today? I'm very happy to see you after 3 months of our holiday. Selamat pagi anak-anakku sekalian, apa kabar kalian semua? Senang sekali ibu bisa berjumpa dengan kalian setelah 3 bulan kita liburan. Actually, we should have our learning process in our school, Adi Sucipto Junior High School, but because of coronavirus, that is why we should study at home. Harusnya kita proses pembelajarannya di dalam kelas di SMPK Adi Sucipto, tapi dikarenakan adanya virus corona, makanya kita belajarnya di rumah saja. Okay, so today we are going to study English. But before that, I want to say congratulations for all of you because you have passed the exam and now you are in 8th grade. Selamat untuk Anda semua karena Anda sudah lulus dalam ujian dan sekarang Anda berada di kelas 8. Okay, today we are going to study about English, and for 8th grade student, especially 8A and 8B, you will be with me. Kita akan belajar bahasa Inggris, khususnya untuk kelas 8A dan 8B. Anda akan bersama dengan saya. Okay, now let's start to study English. The first meeting, we are going to study about expression of asking for attention. Pertemuan kita pada pertama ini, kita akan belajar tentang asking for attention. Have you ever heard this word? Pernah dengar kata ini? I'm sure that you have ever heard it. Maybe you heard it from Eltari Airport or maybe other public places. Pasti pernah dengar ya anak-anakku sekalian. Mungkin Anda mendengarkannya di bandara atau mungkin juga di tempat umum yang lain ya. Oke. Nah, hari ini kita akan belajar bagaimana asking for attention and also how to respond our attention and the last one showing attention, bagaimana cara kita menunjukkan yang namanya attention itu. Before we going to the explanation, I have 3 purposes for you. The first one, after this lesson, students are able to identify and use expression to get other attention. Jadi, habis pelajaran ini, anak-anakku sekalian, Anda diminta untuk bisa mengidentifikasi dan menggunakan ungkapan bagaimana kita mendapatkan perhatian dari orang lain. And second one, students are able to identify and use expression to show attention. Jadi, siswa bisa mengidentifikasi dan menggunakan ungkapan ini untuk show attention, menunjukkan attention atau perhatiannya. And the last one, dan yang ketiga, you will read the dialogue and then answer the question based on the dialogue. Anda akan membaca sebuah dialog dan kemudian Anda menjawab question berdasarkan dialog itu. And for this one, you can find it on our website school. Untuk yang ketiga ini Anda bisa mencari di website sekolah kita ya. Okay, now we come to the explanation. Kita masuk pada penjelasannya. Yang pertama, we start from asking for attention. This expression is used when you need an attention from other people to hear your information. Ungkapan asking for attention ini kita gunakan ketika kita membutuhkan yang namanya atensi atau perhatian dari orang lain untuk bisa mendengarkan informasi dari kita. Nah, di sini Ibu ada beberapa ungkapan yang Anda bisa gunakan. There are some expression we can use to asking for attention, such as first, excuse me. Second, attention please. Third, can I have your attention please? Fourth, may I have your attention please? Fifth, sorry to trouble you. Sixth, sorry to bother you. And the last one, look what I've got here. Nah, dari beberapa ini adik-adik bisa gunakan ketika mau menarik perhatian dari seseorang untuk bisa mendengarkan kita punya pembicaraan. Itu ya. Oke, next. Responding attention. Bagaimana kita merespon perhatian? Nah, di sini Ibu ada beberapa. Ya, I have four. First one, yes, please. Second one, all right. Third one, sure. And the last one, what is it? We move to showing attention. How we show our attention to other people? Bagaimana kita menunjukkan perhatiannya kita kepada orang lain? Nah, the first one we can use I see. Second, well. Third, tell me more. Katakan lagi. Fourth, really? Benarkah? Fifth, is she? Have you? Next, what happened? And here is one of a dialogue. How to asking someone's attention. Look at this. Mr. Campbell, attention please. Students, yes, sir. Mr. Campbell, I'm going to give you the itinerary of our journey. Itinerary, itu rencana perjalanan. Next, students, hooray! Mr. Campbell, may I have your attention, please? Students, shh! Mr. Campbell, thank you. Here is the itinerary, one for each of you. Thank you, sir. Yeah, we come to the end of light show. It means that that's all for today, for this first meeting. And I hope that after you learn this expression, you can practice it in your daily life. Maybe speak with your parents, your brother or your sister. Akhirnya kita sampai pada akhir pertemuan kita, tapi Ibu berharap pada akhir pertemuan ini, setelah adik-adik mempelajari ungkapan ini, adik-adik bisa mempraktikkan dalam kehidupan sehari-hari, mungkin dengan orang tua atau dengan saudara atau juga saudari. Oke. Okay, and finally, don't forget to wash your hand, stay at home, and always keep your social distancing for your health. And on the next meeting, we are going to study about how to check the understanding from other people. And you can read it from your book, your English Bright book. Okay, that's all from me, and I have to say goodbye, but I want to meet you soon, and I hope that we can meet each other as soon as possible. Okay, may God bless you, and bye-bye.